Check 1 2. Hello, good afternoon. Check 1 2. I am going to continue to talk. Don't know what else to say. Have lots of things to say once we start. Check 1 2. Hello, good afternoon. It's 1:12 in the afternoon. I'm going to continue to talk. Check. Hello, check 1 2. Okay, so it's coming through on YouTube, so we're good. Do you want to check this mic? It's a little bit hot on this, on my headset. I'll turn it off. I'm going to turn my headset off now. You're good with that? Check. Okay, here we go. Check 1 2. Making sure we can hear. This is the mic that the bride and groom are going to be using. Is that good? You want me to keep going? Check 1 2. Am I good? Are we good? We're good? Do you want me to keep talking? Okay, I'm going to keep talking. I love to talk. I have a 7-year-old daughter who could talk on this mic for hours if I gave it to her. Talk 1 2, hello, good afternoon, welcome. Anybody who's watching this, tuning in, we are so glad you're here. Give us a wave, give us a like. Check 1 2, hello. Are you good? Ooh, that's getting a little bit. Check 1 2, check. Hello, good afternoon. Do you want me to keep going? Is this good? Okay, keep going. All right. I am looking around. I see a lot of flowers. We got some beautiful candles. We have scripture displayed in a different creative way. I'm just going to keep talking. How's it going? Check 1 2. Good? Okay. So let's put on a little bit of prelude music. I'm going to go and pray with each side, and then we're going to get this show on the road. All right.
Power. is. There is power in the name, and I will adore you.
Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will.
On this, the most exciting Saturday of May 9th, 2020, who gives this bride to this man? Awesome. Alex, Teneya. Let's take a big, deep breath. This is an amazing moment. Yeah, take a moment to enjoy this, just the two of you for this moment. Good. Well, good afternoon, everybody. I know that many of you are joining us online today. And so we're in a pretty much an empty church today, but that's not the end of the world. So for those of you who are, we know there's people tuning from around the world, and we want to welcome you and thank you for being part of this momentous event. Since March, our world has completely changed. Our daily lives have been turned upside down. Our ability to do normal tasks have fundamentally changed, but there is still one thing that does not change. No matter what's going on in our world, love is still at work. God's willingness to love us, and in turn, our willingness to love him, and of course, those around us. Ephesians 5:31 says, gives us a beautiful picture of the great love that grows between a married couple. And it says, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Today, amidst the turmoil of our world, we are here to witness a beautiful moment, the moment when two will become one. In this moment, no social distancing can hold these two back from the deep connection that God is going to create. So why don't we start off today with a prayer as we dedicate this time to the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, love has been your richest and greatest gift to our world. Love between a man and a woman, which matures into marriage, is one of the most beautiful types of loves. And today we celebrate that love. May your blessing be on this wedding service. Protect and guide. Bless Teneya and Alliance in their marriage. Surround them with and us with your love now and forever. Amen. Amen. So, dear friends, it's with great affection that today we join with Teneya and Alex as they gather today on this, the May 9th of 2020, to witness and bless their union and marriage. To this sacred moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure and gift from God to ultimately share with one another. They bring their dreams, which bind them together in an eternal commitment. They bring their gifts and talents, their unique personalities and spirits, which God is going to unite them together as they build their life together. We rejoice with them in thankfulness to the Lord for creating this union that we know was built on friendship, respect, and love. In a few moments, Teneya and Alex will be exchanging vows that will publicly speak of their commitment and love for one another. As we prepare to witness that commitment, let us be reminded of God's design for the marriage relationship. I'm going to invite Alex's mom to come up, and she's going to share with us a scripture reading.
Praise the Lord. I'm so happy today, very, very happy to see this beautiful, I don't know how I can express my feeling. I'm so happy for my son and my daughter-in-law, and I am blessed to have a good friends and to have a family who was there, who support us spiritually and in every way. So I'm going to read the scripture. In Ephesians 5:21 until 31, King James Version. Submitting yourself one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourself into your own husband as into the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as the Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wife be their own husbands in everything. Husband, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he may sanctify and cleanse it with the washing water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot and wrinkle or any such things, but it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own body. He that loved his wife loved himself, for no man ever yet had his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord the church, for we are member of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined into his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. Amen.
All right. Hello. Well, we've woken everybody up there. Perfect. Well, thank you so much, Antoinette. We appreciate you bringing the word to us today. Do you know, I have the privilege in this moment to share just a few words to both Alex and Teneya. I want to start off with this. Marriage can be defined in several different ways. You could describe it as a legal agreement, which is pretty cold, to be honest with you. You could say it's a union between a man and a woman. It's getting a bit warmer. But you could also go with what the Bible says, and it describes a marriage as two becoming one. Now that's where we're getting somewhere. And today I want to propose to you, though, a little bit more in-depth look at what that marriage looks like. I believe at the very core of what you are about to start here today is a conversation. I think that's what you're called to do. The conversation at its very core is an exchange of thoughts and ideas and opinions, observations and feelings that two people share with one another. I believe that's what the Bible is talking about when it describes marriage. It's about two distinct individuals becoming one flesh. God unites them. But the marriage is an ongoing union. It's not just a one-time thing. And at the core of that union, I think, is the conversation. God brings you together as one, but we are tasked with the duty to build that connection through a robust and alive conversation. It's interesting, I had the opportunity to meet with Alex and Teneya to talk about this day, but we did it over Zoom at that point, and so we were meeting digitally. And we talked about, of course, this service, but also we talked about their relationship. And I asked them a bunch of questions about, you know, how did your relationship start? You know, who started, who did this, who did that? And they shared with me a number of these stories. Well, they met over social media, so it is truly 2020, so we realize that that's a possibility now. And let it be known, and I'm going to put this in for Alex, he was the first to make the move, although, of course, that's just sending a message, but he did do that, and so let's give him some credit. Teneya shared that she had been, we got a clap, that's good. Teneya shared that she had been praying for a godly man, and almost immediately both Alex and Teneya felt that there was a connection between the two of them. They felt that God was up to something. But it was what they did next that really impressed me. These two, early on in their relationship, met up at, of course, all places here in Edmonton, West Edmonton Mall. And not only did they didn't go to shop or watch movies or even go bowling or anything else you can do in this mall. No, they met at a small cafe area in a very classy area of the mall, I have to say. It's actually called, I Googled it, Europa Boulevard. I mean, I guess they really wanted to say they met in Europe. And so they would often meet in this European-styled area of the mall. In this little cafe area, they'd get something to drink, and they would talk. They would share their thoughts and their opinions, their views. They would tell stories. They would spend hours and hours in this area in conversation. There was even one time when they were talking so long that they lost track of time to the point that a security guard came over to tell them that it was already past 11 o'clock and they were sitting in one of North America's largest malls talking. So the reality is, Alex and Teneya have discovered the most important part to any thriving relationship, and that's a vibrant conversation. So, Teneya and Alex, keep the conversation alive. Of all the marriage relationships that I've encountered over the years as a pastor, I've discovered that those that are struggling are the ones that let the conversation diminish. Your marriage will thrive as you engage in this life-giving conversation. Now, you've shown us that you've done a pretty good job at getting it going, and so good job. But I want to kind of address each of you separately now, that God actually, your Heavenly Father, has some time-tested ways, some advice to each of you that's going to help you keep this conversation going. Interestingly, the Bible does separate it for advice to you, Alex, and advice to you, Teneya. There's a bit of a change for each of you. So let's start with Alex. This is your advice that comes from Ephesians 5:25. It says, "Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it." Alex, you are the head of this new marriage relationship. Some men sometimes see that as a prideful thing, yet when you look into these words, the Apostle Paul is being inspired by the Holy Spirit and is trying to tell you today that you discover that as the head of this marriage, you are the chief of sacrificial love. You, as Teneya's husband, are meant to keep the conversation alive through the daily expression of your sacrificial love towards her. This means that you're going to put aside your needs in that moment to provide for her needs. The Apostle Paul uses later on in this chapter that you should love Teneya as you love yourself, and I have not yet met one man who isn't good at loving themselves. And so love her in that way. Focus on making her feel valued and important. Remember the value of romance and tell her often that she is your beautiful bride. Don't stop being creative in the ways that you remind her of your love. Alex, keep Teneya and her needs at the top of your to-do list, and you will fulfill your part of keeping that conversation alive. Teneya, your guidance reads like this. It says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. Teneya, your guidance is a little bit different, as it takes into account the way that Alex will feel loved by you. The verse I read to you uses the word submit. And in that original language, that has the idea of kind of being subject to or subordinate. And you could say that it really means to respect him. And this idea of respect or to be subordinate often gets a negative connotation in our culture today. How people would say, well, that's not good. She shouldn't have to be subordinate. But let me remind you that when you look at the Trinity, that Jesus is subject to the Father, and the Holy Spirit is also subject to the Son. And they had a perfect relationship, never once being, you know, used or abused. So you are called to respect Alex. As his wife, you have the opportunity to show him love in ways that no one else can. I want to encourage you to notice his strong points more often than you do his weak ones. He will need your encouragement more than your criticism. He'll need your support more than your observations. And I encourage you to respect him. Support him as a man and as your husband. Let him know that you believe in him and that he is your only and the best in your life. Spend time doing things that you both enjoy. And as you do this, you're going to keep that conversation alive. Now, a note for both of you. If at any point you're wondering, I wonder how this conversation is going between the two of us, ask. Just say, hey, how do you think I'm doing? How do you think we're doing? Often just by asking that question, you can clear the lines of communication and find that your marriage relationship can thrive. So finally, after following your specific guidance, I want to encourage you to keep one last thing that you both can do that is a conversation keeper. And the famous passage from 1 Corinthians 13 describes what true love looks like. We hear things like love is patient and it's enduring, it's kind, it's humble, it's faithful, and more. Can I encourage you, sprinkle that type of love into every conversation in your marriage? Let me tell you, there will be times where you feel a little frustrated, maybe even times where you feel hurt or annoyed or angry. It's normal. We all face that. But in that moment, choose to add love to the conversation, and you'll see that conversation quickly change, and your relationship will go back to thriving. So Teneya and Alex, you started your friendship and this relationship with a conversation, and today is simply the formal moment of you deciding to make that conversation a lifelong one. And I've reminded you of God's distinct guidance to you as for a thriving marriage conversation. And now begins the journey when you will continue to keep the conversation thriving through the ups and downs of life. Stay true to what you have started, and I promise you, you will see this conversation become more beautiful than you could have ever imagined. At this point, I'm going to ask the bride and groom a question, and so... Alliance, will you have Teneya to be your wife, to live together as friend and mate? Will you love her as a person, respect her as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep her beside you as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Teneya, will you have Alliance to be your husband, to live together as friend and mate? Will you love him as a person, respect him as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep him beside you as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Thank you. At this point, the bride and groom have prepared their own vows, and so we're going to start with Alex as he shares his vows with Teneya.
Teneya, from the day we met, I knew that God blessed me with a beautiful lady like no other. From the start, you've blessed me with your gentle, kind, loving spirit. In the past year and a half, our love for one another has flourished so much. Me and you have grown so much spiritually, and I'm so glad that I get to pursue Christ with you for the rest of my life. You are such a beautiful, smart, godly woman, full of smiles, love, and I pray that it never goes away. From this moment on, knowing that we are about to become one, I vow to understand that every decision that I make will fully affect you. I vow to love you, lead you, protect you, and support you for the rest of our lives. I vow to be faithful to you and to put your needs above mine, regardless of the circumstances. I promise to treasure you for all that you are and for eternity. I promise to lead you in a Christ-centered, godly marriage, and to keep pursuing Christ for myself and for us so I can grow more wise and become better for us. I promise to always take care of you and never stop giving you tickles. I vow to always do my best to make you smile, to make you smile and laugh, because those are the two greatest things in this world for me. In our time together, I promise to do everything in my power to help you accomplish all of the beautiful dreams that you have in mind. Teneya, I am so thankful for you. God brought us together, and I am blessed beyond measure. I love you so much, and I can't wait to start this life together. I love you.
We have to say that Teneya was a little worried that Alex was going first, and she might want to do some edits, she told us in the practice, but I'm sure her words are going to be absolutely beautiful.
Alliance, my best friend, my biggest blessing, and my God-given soulmate. From the moment we met, I knew there was something special between us. I had instant peace, almost like an immediate answer from God, that after everything I've been through, that this is what God had waiting for me. The days in the past when I felt like giving up, felt like I wasn't worthy of finding a godly man that would love and respect me. When I didn't know where to turn and I felt lost, all made sense after I laid my life down for Christ and I received the blessing of meeting you. Coming out of a few horrible relationships that took everything out of me, he got to my head and made me feel like I wasn't good enough for God to have a man made perfectly for me. But you were the light at the end of my tunnel. You were the answer to all of mine and my family's prayers, and I'm so thankful that I have a man who loves me, but most importantly, loves God more. I'm thankful to have a man that prays for me, who cares for me, and not just says he loves me, but shows me that he loves me. Even with your faults and weaknesses, I want you to know that you are the most amazing man that I have ever met. Today is the day we start the rest of our lives together, cleaving as one, to share the ups and the downs, the good and the bad, through sickness and health, and anything else that comes our way. From this day forward, I promise that I will always love you unconditionally. I promise to always keep Jesus first and center our relationship around him. I promise to always respect you, honor you, to support you, and to encourage you, to be loyal to you, and to hold your hand through the good times and bad. I promise to try my best to clean the really dirty dishes, even when the chunky food makes me want to gag. I promise to never let you win at Uno and always play every 4+ I have. And I promise to blow dry my hair in the bathroom instead of our bedroom when you ask, because I know you hate the sound of it. I promise to tell you when we need to be places a half hour before we actually need to be there, so we can always be on time. And I promise to not smack your butt in public, but only when there's a lot of people around. I vow to be humble, to be selfless, and to try every day to make you smile until your cheeks hurt. The sky is the limit for us, and I can't wait to see what goals we will achieve together. Today is the beginning of the rest of our lives. Today I give my heart to you so you will never be alone, and you will always have a helper. I love you so much, and I can't wait to share this adventure with you and our future family.
I think you knocked it out of the park. I think you did fantastic. At this point, Alex and Teneya are going to exchange rings. The exchanging of rings has traditionally been an opportunity to express the couple's promise of faithfulness to each other. The unending circle of a ring is the symbol of eternity. The wedding ring is an outward expression of an inward bond, as two hearts unite as one, promising to love one another for fidelity and for all eternity. Wearing of the wedding bands throughout the couple's lifetime is a way to tell others of their commitment to be faithful. So now, as a token of your love and your deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, you, Alliance, may place the ring on the finger of your bride. And then repeat after me. Teneya, I give you this ring.
Teneya, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol for my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
And by the same token, Teneya, you may place the ring onto the finger of your groom, and then repeat after me. Alliance, I give you this ring.
Alliance, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
Here comes the big moment. Here we go. So I charge you both to be true to the vows that you have just taken and made for each other. As you look for faithfulness and happiness in your married life, it is only as each of you faithfully does your part that true and lasting happiness can be found. For as much as you, Alliance Essawifi, and you, Teneya Collins, have consented together in holy marriage and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged your faithfulness to each other, and have declared the same by the giving of a ring and by the joining of hands, acting in the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel and the government of Alberta, and looking to heaven for divine sanction, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Alliance, you may now kiss your bride. You guys are fantastic. Let's take a moment after that to dedicate you guys to the Lord. Abba, Father, we come to you in this moment, and we thank you for how you have brought Alliance and Teneya together as one. And today marks the beginning of their journey. Lord, it's day one of many, many days, many, many memories that are going to come about this relationship. And we ask that you would bless this union. We ask that you would help them keep the conversation alive and well. And we pray that you would continue, that they would continually seek you and trust you in all areas of their marriage and life. I pray that they would grow closer together as they go closer to you. We bless them in your holy name we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, at this time, Alex and Teneya are going to sign the register, and their witnesses will join them. Come on, this is good. Well, the family wants you to know, although I am sure I can speak for them, they would have loved for this moment to be in person, and we're so thankful for technology that you can tune in. Please send them, I'll throw this in, send them any of your well wishes. They want to hear from you. They want to know how it was as you were watching it online today. So please don't be afraid to send them a note. Make it long. Make them read. They want to hear those things. They also want you to know that leaving right after this ceremony, they're going outside to the parking lot. I believe it's a nice sunny day here in Alberta, and they're going to cut some cake together, which is going to be fantastic, and then they're going to share their first dance in the parking lot. So COVID-19 is not stopping these two from enjoying themselves, and we're glad to hear it. Well, let me just pronounce the benediction over both of you today. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Yes, this is it. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my distinct privilege to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Asawiffe.
I give you glory.